Welcome to Treasury Notes, a show dedicated to the latest news and information from the Office of West Virginia State Treasurer John Perdue. I'm your host, Gina Long. On our last show, we took a look back at some of the major accomplishments and initiatives of the State Treasurer's Office over the past year. But this month, we turn our attention to the Treasurer's goals for 2010. Today, we talk with Treasurer Perdue, and we'll also be joined by a financial analyst with Mercer Investment Consulting. They're going to answer some questions about the current economy and how it might affect us here in West Virginia. Before we get to that, many people around the state have decided to strive for financial success in 2010. For some people, it's as simple as creating a budget. For others, it's about investing into a retirement system. Here are a few tips and tricks some people are using to prepare for their financial future.
What I like to do as a good financial tip is during the beginning of the year, after I do my taxes and get my return, I like to use that toward something that's going to benefit me in the future. So maybe I make an extra house payment or make a credit card payment, or even better, I may use it toward my retirement and invest it in, say, a Roth IRA.
Actually, I'm trying to stick more closely to the budget, maybe eat a little less fast food, do a little bit more planning as far as the, you know, the food goes, and just trying to cut corners.
My goal for 2010 is basically to increase the net worth. Yeah, I'd love to end it with a bigger savings account that I started it with.
Mainly just to pay off my home early and maybe build up a savings for my kids.
A lot of ideas on how to be financially successful in 2010. And I'm joined now by West Virginia State Treasurer John Perdue and Jeffrey Busick, a chartered financial analyst with Mercer Investment Consulting. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us here today. Now, before we get started, we do want to remind our viewers that this discussion should not be considered investment advice. If you do have any questions about your personal financial situation, you should contact an investment professional for a specific consultation. But let's start out by talking a little bit about where the economy is today and how we got to this point. Back in 2008, the economic crisis really happened so quickly and so violently. It was uncharted territory for the most part. So looking back, do you think that in 2009 we started to recover and are kind of on that path to recovery?
Well, I would have to say yes. You know, most of the economic data that's come out would support that we have entered a recovery of some sorts, although it's not as robust as perhaps we'd like to have seen or have seen in the past. It's about half as the growth, that is about half of what we normally would see coming out of a recession. So we have seen growth, and we have seen positive growth come from that terrible time in late 2008 and early 2009, but right now I think we're going to continue to see very moderate growth as we head into 2010.
And hopefully on a statewide level, we're in the same situation where we will be starting to recover.
Well, yes, I agree with Jeff on that. And Jeff, let me thank you for being on our show today. I appreciate that very much. Our citizens can get to see kind of what's going on a national level. But on the state level, our people are still concerned. As you've seen from the interviews there, they're talking about savings. You wouldn't have heard people talking about saving because they just want to spend for tomorrow until the financial crisis hit. Now people are talking about saving for that important extra house payment, or maybe realizing they need to save in case the roof starts leaking and have to do repairs, or the refrigerator breaks down, or the car breaks down. Now, you know, in West Virginia, the growth is starting to come back. People are starting to get some of the jobs back, but we always fall a lot farther trail behind other states. And though we're at 8.9% unemployment, while the national level is about over 10%, we're doing well. We're one of the better states in the country because we have balanced the budget and we have cut back, and our citizens have done well too in managing this financial crisis. But I see that we can still have some fallback here in this coming year. So I'm confident that we're prepared to meet the challenge.
Yeah, and we're going to talk a little bit about the unemployment rates a little later in the show as well. As far as our current market right now, how does it compare to years past? I mean, what kind of a situation are we in if you take a look at the 10, 20 years ago from now?
Well, you know, GDP growth is obviously come back, and there's an exhibit here. You can see the downturn in the economy where we saw the negative growth that occurred in the recession, and we've started to come out of that. And as I said earlier, this growth, while positive, is about half of what we would expect to see coming out of a recession. As far as the financial markets, obviously we went through an unprecedented downturn, maybe a little bit more than we would have expected given what was going on at the time, but we've actually come out of it in a very, very strong and euphoric way beginning in March of last year. So we may have overreacted in the markets in 2008 and early 2009, and we may have overreacted a little bit on the positive side to come back. And as of late, we're seeing a little bit of that give back in the stock markets, retrenching a little bit because people are trying to figure out where this economy is going to go. A lot of cost cutting happened last year, and that was manifest in earnings and improvement in earnings. But you can only cut costs so far. And at some point, you have to try to build that top line growth, that sales growth. And that's what we're going to be focusing on in 2010. How sustainable are those earnings that we've seen in 2009, and are they going to grow?
Now, when you talk about the economy and predicting the future, a lot of people look to the economic indicators. For example, the Consumer Price Index. What does that really tell us right now? What message is being delivered by the Consumer Price Index right now?
Well, there's another exhibit here that I've referenced, and you can see that Consumer Price Index actually fell pretty quickly as we entered the recession, and now we're starting to see upticks in not only the Consumer Price Index, but also the Producer Price Index. When you strip out food and energy in the Consumer Price Index, we're up a moderate amount. But right now we've popped up, and you can see the trend is upward. Obviously that message is are we going to see inflation creep in here? And if we do, what would effect that have on the marketplace? And I would say that if we started to see rapid inflation, it would obviously be a negative. But right now, I don't think anyone's forecasting rapid inflation by any stretch. And in fact, if anything, we'll probably see interest rates stay pretty low throughout most of this year.
What about consumer confidence? Treasurer, you were talking about a lot of people right now wanting to save, and that all goes into consumer confidence.
Well, you know, the confidence in the state of West Virginia, and I think nationally, people are still very frustrated, especially at Washington, D.C., and what is happening there. They're frustrated of what they think is giveaway programs and the huge debt. And so when it comes to confidence, there's good debt and there's bad debt. You know, there's good debt, like your house, a long-term debt of your house, and something that you're going to pay dividends for you long-term, and a 457 or 401k that you're investing in. Those are good debts. Education is a good debt, investing in your children's education. I'm very pro-education, as you well know, 529 plans, things like that that you're investing in for your children's future. But there's also bad debt, and I think our consumers learned about that bad debt. You know, the credit card is a bad debt. Don't want anybody to get that number, but anyhow, the bad debt is this, is that this is one of the worst debts you can have. If you're not paying this card off every month, you have a bad debt. And if you got two or three of these in your pocketbook, you have a bad debt. And so those are bad debts that you got to look at. If you're going to go out this spring after this winter thaw and buy a boat and get on the Kanawha River or go boating to our lakes around, that could be a bad debt if you can't afford that. So you have to look at your budget and decide what's a good debt, what's a bad debt, and you got to really manage your money in this financial crisis that we're facing right now.
Yeah, and we talk a lot about consumer confidence, people spending. What's it going to take, Jeff, to get that consumer confidence back up there?
I think clearly it's going to be job growth. You know, without a steady income or without an income that you're used to, that's going to obviously manifest in how you spend your money. The consumer confidence has dropped off precipitously from this economy and where we saw it. It bottomed out earlier in 2009. It's actually started to come back up, obviously not at the levels that we've seen it, And I actually was one of the few people, I think, that thought we'd see some spike up, if you will, in retail sales at the end of the year as we got into the holiday season as a result of the pickup in consumer confidence. And we did see a year-over-year increase, but I think a lot of that was a result of 2008 and the massive retention and spending that went on in that holiday season. So we did see a pickup at the end of this past year, but not at the levels, again, that we would have liked to have seen. So again, moderate growth or slow to moderate growth is what we're seeing. And I think the fact that consumer confidence is picking up is a plus. But I think longer term, and I would have to maybe side with what the treasurer said here, is that you're going to see people start to look at their own balance sheet and income statement and try to get that debt, as he put it, the bad debt, whittled down. And they're going to start to save more, which is actually going to be good personally for them, but help at the same time limit the growth in the economy.
You know, you had mentioned about Christmas sales in December. Does that give us any hope, or is it a sense of false hope that gives?
I think the year over year was a positive, but I think what it does is just relay on that it's not going to be a euphoric recovery here like we're used to, and it's going to be more gradual and prolonged. We went down pretty fast, and the markets came back pretty fast, but now as people kind of rethink things and go back to where they were before this happened and where they are today, there's a lot more caution in the marketplace, a lot more caution in the retail consumer's mindset than there was in the past.
Yeah, because people today, with technology today and with instant TV today, right, they can see what's going on a national level. And then when they see that Home Depot is cutting jobs, or they see Sam's cutting jobs, you know, they're still worried about their own job. And it's about jobs, as Jeff said. It's about creating those jobs. Now, in West Virginia, we've been lucky. We're a natural resource state, and our natural resources are keeping us going. You know, we have an $18 million surplus. I think this month we'll have a $30 million plus surplus, maybe as much as $60 million. Now, people are probably saying the treasurer's crazy, but looking at the numbers, I think we're doing well, and I see some jobs returning in those industries in West Virginia. Now, on a national level, people are going to still look at those layoffs and think, well, you know, I've got to really manage my budget well, as Jeff says, and protect my own interests. And I think there's still great concern out there, yes.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of concern out there. Switching gears a little bit, how about the value of the U.S. dollar? How is that holding up in this economy?
Well, you know, the dollar has been beaten down pretty far and actually started to rebound here in the last quarter of 2009 and into 2010. Talking to our economists in-house at Mercer, we feel the dollar is fairly valued at this point. I don't see it going up much against major currencies, and I don't see it really falling much. So with a fairly valued dollar, you know, exports are going to not be as robust. I mean, obviously, if the dollar falls, that actually oftentimes does result in increase in exports. But right now, with it fairly valued, I think we're going to see steady export flow as well.
All right. Treasurer, anything to add about just the value of the dollar?
Well, I believe if you look at West Virginia, you know, yes, I agree with Jeff. The dollar, you know, the value of the dollar has gone up on a national level and on a world economy that we compete in, and it's looking a lot better. But people are going to still hold on to their dollar here in the state of West Virginia because they understand the value of that dollar, and they feel like they may need it. And I think that's why you see so much savings going on. And it amazes me that the people are putting money in savings accounts and banks are not even making any interest.
Right.
You know, they need to look at maybe other alternatives. I'm,
sure.
I'm glad they're saving, but I hope that if they're going to save that money, they'll look at CDs or other options where they at least get a little bit more interest than just that, you know, I call it chicken feed interest out there. I'm an old country boy, but I hope they start looking at that and, you know, and they continue to save. But I really believe this economy is starting to turn, and I believe that as the job market turns, there'll be more confidence in going out there and purchasing things that will grow this economy and put more people back to work.
All right. Well, we have a great discussion going on here, but I'm going to pause for a quick moment to take a break. When we come back, we will discuss the unemployment rate and some of the local economic indicators. We'll be right back.
We find all kinds of items, and that becomes unclaimed property, and it mounts into millions of dollars. It could be stock, it could be CDs, but it could also be a diamond ring or a gold watch of your dad's. We returned over $50 million to the people of West Virginia. I'm proud of that. You can go on our website, you can look at the names and see if your name's on there or someone that you recognize. We set the standards in a nation in returning unclaimed property.
Welcome back to Treasury Notes. I'm your host, Gina Long. I'm here with State Treasurer John Perdue and Mercer Investment Consultant Jeffrey Busick to talk about the economy. But we do want to remind our viewers that today's discussion should not be considered specific investment advice. Now, I pulled this number. According to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics, West Virginia's unemployment rate in November of 2009 was 8.4%, which is still under the national unemployment rate of about 10% for that same month in 2009. The unemployment rate is always a big economic indicator, as you both were saying earlier. What does this really mean for us right now? How can we put these numbers into perspective?
Well, from a historical perspective, if you look back to the last major recession that we had back in the early 80s, we're still under the unemployment rate that we were at that point in time. But nonetheless, we're a lot higher than we have been on average as of late. But looking at the unemployment rate, it's a lagging indicator. It's not one that will move downward as the economy, as in ahead of the economy expanding. It'll move downward as the economy expands. And right now at 10%, while it drifted down slightly in November and December from where it was in October, there was a pop in initial job claims in December. It was up over 480,000. 400,000 is sort of the threshold that people refer to as a barometer for the recovery. So I would say, looking at that, we're going to probably continue to see that number creep up in the first half of 2010. It might get as high as 10.5%, but I would suspect that as this economy moves on and if this economy is sustainable, we're going to see that number start to come back down from where we are now. But it's going to take a lot longer than it has in years past.
Yeah, this is long term. I mean, we're not out of the woods yet when it comes to these high unemployment numbers.
No, not at all. And in fact, you know, when you look back at Western Pennsylvania in the early 80s, when that recession hit, the steel industry, you know, really went through a lot, and I think the auto industry is going through it now. And I think the result of the unemployment rate spiking as high as it has is some of these jobs that were there are gone, and so people are going to have to retool and revisit what they do with their careers going forward as a result of that.
Yeah, we talk about the unemployment rate, and then you put inflation on top of that. A lot of people without jobs dealing with inflation. What role does inflation play in the current economy?
Well, it'll obviously stifle growth if it comes back. I think the Fed right now is going to do everything they can to make sure that this economy grows at the expense of maybe ignoring inflation short term. But nonetheless, if inflationary pressures creep in here, I think you're going to see the Fed come back and start to battle that, because that's obviously going to inhibit growth. And people that aren't making as much, their dollar's not going to buy as much. So the better they can manage that, you know, the better off the economy will be as we recover.
Yeah, and we were talking about the unemployment rate. You know, people in West Virginia are concerned about jobs. That's a big concern right now.
You know, we're way below that 10% percent, yeah, 8.4%, sure. But we're still concerned about that, because I think people's concern is, what did this stimulus package do? You know, it put a lot of money, it saved quite a few jobs.
Yeah.
But can that be sustained, or is that unemployment going to grow on a national level? And that's the picture that everybody's looking at right now, and I'm concerned about that, because if unemployment continues to rise, and which I think it'll still stay, in, like Jeff said, in the 10%, but if it goes to 11, 12, hope it doesn't, I think that really affects this economy tremendously and affects what people's outlook is on the future of what they're going to do with their budget, and that's very concerning here in the not only in West Virginia, but I think on a national level.
I mean, overall, Treasurer, how do you foresee the economy affecting the state budget and people here in West Virginia?
Well, I have confidence in our state budget because we started planning. We have the rainy day fund. We have put together. We are a natural resource state, like I said. Our coal, though we see some problems with permitting and so forth, with coal, I really think it is still going to sustain the state budget, and we'll continue to hold our own. Gas, oil and gas industry is growing big in West Virginia. So I really believe that we can manage our way through this crisis situation. And like last month, we had a surplus in our budget that nobody anticipated. I think we're going to have a surplus this month as well. And so I believe as we walk our way through this crisis situation, West Virginia is in good position to really get through this financial crisis a lot better than a lot of states in the nation that don't have the natural resources that we have.
Jeffrey, what about the federal funds? How is that affecting local banks?
Well, the government and the Fed as a whole has pushed rates down from where they were before this environment. The Fed funds rate right now is down in the 0 to 0.5% range. It's at unprecedented historic lows. The positive to that to the banks is that their cost of capital is very low. I think that the real recovery that the Fed was looking for in recapitalization in the financial institutions was, okay, let's keep your cost of funds low and allow you to earn a spread on your income from loans. Part of the problem is that the banks haven't lent as much as people would have thought they would have. But nonetheless, they have recapitalized. They've issued new stock, new capital sources have come into play. But I think right now with Fed funds as low as they are and the opportunity set ripe for banks to lend again, once that money starts to get back out into the economy again, it's going to be a positive.
I really believe that too. I really believe banks is a key to the future of this economy. Right now they're holding on to their cash. They're cash flush. And if they start reaching out and lending out to the consumer, getting this economy moving in the right direction, it changes the whole picture. And I think that is critical in the future here in 2010. What does the banks do?
What about the ability to buy and sell homes? How is the economy affecting all that?
Well, I mean, the stimulus package obviously had a positive impact on home sales. Sales market in general has been up and down. There's been pockets of months after month where it looked like it was on a recovery, followed by a decline. But again, it really comes back to the confidence that the people have in job creations. If you don't have a steady income, it makes it harder for you to buy a house. Now, the stimulus program that's in place is going to roll off in April. It may be renewed. I'm not sure. We'll wait to see. But it's been a positive. There's no question about it. And those numbers that we've seen on the upside, the numbers that have been positive in the housing industry, have been helped by that.
But is it a false hope? I think that's what a lot of people are worried about, that the stimulus money, while it's a good thing, it's just maybe too temporary.
Well, it is, at least on a long-term basis, obviously it's going to be temporary. But I think if it enables someone who can afford a house to get into a house, and not leverage themselves like people had done in this real estate bust that we've gone through, I think that's a positive thing. That gets them into the house, gets them the tax benefits of home ownership, and that helps. But again, you're right, it is a temporary thing, and not everyone can benefit from it, but it is enough, at least today, to show some positive incremental effects on the real estate market.
And I really think that it's a buyer's market in a lot of parts of a lot of the country.
No question.
Now in West Virginia here, it's not necessarily a buyer's market. It can be, but our housing real estate has not been affected as much as a lot of the other parts of the country. But I believe in lots of parts of the country, if you see that movement in the real estate market moving in a positive way, you're going to see a great movement in this economy returning back to where it was.
Let's quickly talk a little bit about recovery. As we move forward in 2010, what are some of the things we should expect to see?
Well, I think we've, as I said before, we've already moved into the a phase of the recovery. I think what we're going to see is continued discussion about interest rates. I think that's going to be a key component to this When is the Fed going to raise rates? Because that's going to have an effect on the markets. There's no question about it. And how that affects the markets will affect the overall economy. But I think that that's going to be one of the more visible and discussed items is when is the Fed going to raise rates? They're going to do that at some point. Most people predict it won't be until either the end of this year or early in 2011 before they start to push rates back up. But I think that'll be a key thing. And I think, too, again, as I said earlier, as far as the market returns that we've seen, that we saw in 2009, you know, we're going to see a little bit of retrenchment because I think we've obviously kind of shot past maybe where we would be. We still think the stock market's very valued right now. So that might just result in some noise up and down for a while before we get any true directional flow up or down out of the stock market. But I think clearly, as I've said, you know, a couple times now, the growth that we've seen isn't what we'd like coming out of recession, but clearly it's growth. And that, you know, absent anything else, it's positive, which is a plus.
So time is a big ally for investors.
I would have to say that it is.
Yeah, absolutely. All right. We're going to take another break right now. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
The primary function of the Treasurer's Office is cash management. People don't realize that we are the largest bank in the state of West Virginia. People have no idea how much money comes through the Treasurer's Office, over $13 billion now. I pride myself in being the best state in managing money in the nation. I'm the banker of state government. We are your bank. We take care of your money.
Welcome back once again. This is Treasury Notes, a show dedicated to the latest news and information of the State Treasurer's Office. Jeffrey Busick and Treasurer Perdue are here talking about the economy today, and we're just about ready to wrap things up. But before we wrap things up, I wanted to give you guys a chance to kind of just talk about a recap and where we are today in this economy and what you foresee in the future. Jeff, I'll start with you. Just where are we at today? I mean, are we in a good situation? Are we getting better?
I think we're in a good situation. We're in certainly a better situation than we were a year ago. And I think that the consumer is thinking more positively. And they're taking healthy steps on their own personal financial situation, saving more, working down that debt. It's going to be a gradual recovery, and interest rates are going to play into this. It's going to affect mortgages. It's going to affect auto loans. And so that's going to be a key concern as we go forward in this year, is following interest rate movements and when the Fed decides to start pushing those up.
All right. And Treasurer, just a recap of how the economy right now is really going to affect the state here in West Virginia.
Well, you know, Jeff, first of all, once again, thanks for coming on the show, because I think it really gives West Virginians opportunity to see that we're competing in a world economy. And you brought some real insight into that. And I agree with Jeff. I think we are on the way to recovery. This is a long process. You know, we didn't get in this mess overnight. We're not going to get out of this mess overnight. And yes, people are impatient. They want to turn the light on and turn it off when they want and hope that it will change everything. I believe West Virginia is definitely in a lot better position than most states. Financially, with the state budget, they're in great shape. I think with our citizens, we're in good shape in the real estate market. I think our citizens have a tendency to save a lot more than most citizens do around this country. So I am confident that we will come through this financial crisis probably better than any we've ever come through in our lifetime in West Virginia. So I'm real happy about that.
All right. State Treasurer John Perdue and Jeff Busick with Mercer Investment Consulting, thank you both so much for being here today. We really appreciate it. And thanks to all the staff who helped make this show possible. Keeping you informed on the Library Television Network, I'm Gina Long. Thanks for watching.